Your bank account is overdrawn by $155. You don't realize this and write another check for $47. Then the bank charges you $30 for being overdrawn. Use an integer to represent your account balance. So if your account is overdrawn, that means that's money that you owe. So if your account is overdrawn by $155, we could represent that by a negative integer. So in this case, it would be negative 155. But then when you write another check for $47, this is also money that you will owe that you don't have in your account. So we can represent this check by a negative number as well. So we'll add a negative 47 to this amount. And then the bank charges you $30 for being overdrawn, which again is more money that you owe that you don't have. So we'd have to add another negative 30 to this amount. So whether we know how to add negative integers or not, we should be able to figure this out using logic. You can think of all these as losses or amounts that you have to pay. So what we could do is find the sum of 155, 47, and 30. And because they're all amounts that we owe, we could represent this with a negative integer. So 5 plus 7 would be 12. We'd carry a 1. 1 plus 5 plus 4, that'd be 10. Plus 3 would be 13. Carry a 1. So we owe a total of $232. And because we owe that amount, we could represent this as a negative integer. So this sum will be negative 232. And because we're talking about dollars, we can go ahead and put units on this. This would be negative $232.